welcome to this very special show where we talk about the late actor Sushant Singh Rajput on his first death anniversary. The actor was found hanging in his Mumbai apartment on the 14th of June, and his tragic demise opened a can of worms in Bollywood, where Kangana Ranaut accused big filmmakers of actively sidelining Sushant Singh Rajput and bringing up the topic of nepotism to the forefront once again. While there were some star kids who actually said that the first film can be their big break, but after that, they're only in the film industry on merit. Let's take a look at this raging controversy once again.
सुशांत सिंह राजपूत की मौत ने हम सबको झिंझोड़ के रख दिया है, मगर कुछ लोग जो इस चीज़ में माहिर हैं कि कैसे एक पैरेलल नैरेटिव चलाना है, वो इस तरह से चला रहे हैं कि हाँ, जिनका दिमाग कमजोर होता है वो ये डिप्रेशन में आते हैं और सुसाइड वगैरह कमिट करते हैं।
In an industry ruled by cliques and camps, nepotism is the unsaid reality. The favoritism debate first made headlines when Kangana called Karan Johar the flag bearer of nepotism on his own show Coffee with Karan.
You think flag bearer of nepotism.
And the accusations returned with full force a day after Sushant Singh Rajput's tragic death, when the National Award winner released a video message where she slammed the film industry of playing the favoritism card once again. According to Kangana, the industry treated Sushant unfairly and he didn't get his due, despite his intelligence, a series of strong performances and box office successes.
अगर आप देखें उनके कुछ लास्ट पोस्ट, वो क्लियरली कह रहे हैं कि लोगों को बैक कर रहे हैं कि प्लीज मेरी फिल्म में देखो, मेरा कोई गॉड फादर नहीं है, मुझे निकाल दिया जाएगा इस इंडस्ट्री से. अपने इंटरव्यू में वो जाहिर कर रहे हैं कि मुझे क्यों नहीं ये इंडस्ट्री अपनाती है, आई फील लाइक अ लेफ्ट ओवर. तो क्या इसमें इस हादसे की कोई बुनियाद नहीं है? किस तरह से अगर किसी और स्टार किड ने इस तरह से 6-7 के साल के स्पैन में कार पहुंचे, जैसे उनको कोई डेब्यू की कोई अक्नॉलेजमेंट, कोई अवार्ड नहीं मिला, या केदारनाथ या धोनी या छिछोरे जैसी फिल्म, एक गली बॉय जैसी एक वाहियात फिल्म को सारे अवार्ड मिलते, छिछोरे इज द बेस्ट फिल्म एंड द बेस्ट डायरेक्टर, उनकी फिल्म को कोई अक्नॉलेजमेंट नहीं.
The actor's allegations opened a can of worms in Bollywood once again, where a host of A-listers and filmmakers had their own piece to say. From Shekhar Kapoor to Anubhav Sinha and even Kangana herself, it was probably one of the first time that celebrities openly shared their views on the so-called elite club of Bollywood or the Bollywood Mafia, as Kangana had famously stated on Coffee with Karan way back in 2017, accusing the filmmaker of giving opportunities to star kids only. Post this episode, Karan Johar couldn't get over Kangana exposing him and other industry bigwigs over the unfair treatment of actors who did not hail from a filmy family. The filmmaker, along with Saif Ali Khan and Varun Dhawan, poked fun at Kangana at the IFA Awards in New York City in 2017. But the joke was on Bollywood's elite trio, as they shot themselves in the foot by stating the obvious. The mudslinging didn't end here. Karan Johar blew it up further at the LSE India Forum in the same year, where he not only used the platform to criticize Kangana for constantly playing the victim card, but also said that she is blaming Bollywood for terrorizing her. This tug of war between the outsiders and the insiders continued for a long time thereafter, with several actors speaking about their struggles in Bollywood.
An outsider will always remain an outsider. The journey is always going to be difficult. I remember when I came to Mumbai after finishing my BE in electronics, you know, I was a qualified engineer. I just thought that approach is going to be different, but it was not so different. I never got an entry to any office. No one was ready to pick up your calls. No one was ready to see your pictures. So I knew that, I realized in those 6-8 months that this journey is going to be tough. If you have the nerves of steel, then only come to this industry. Don't expect wonders to happen.
As an outsider, there are so many things that you keep in mind. Like in our first film also, there was this feeling of like they might feel that we can't do it, and they might say ki ye film nahi, aap koi aur kar lena, aisa kuch, matlab film chhin jayegi. तो ये सारे स्ट्रेस तो होता ही है, बट आई थिंक विद अ फिल्म लाइक दंगल अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स चेंज. अ लॉट ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स हैव डन सो मेनी मूवीज एंड दे आर स्टिल स्ट्रगलिंग टू गेट दैट काइंड ऑफ अ लाइमलाइट और रिकॉग्निशन इन द इंडस्ट्री. टैलेंट दिखता है और टैलेंट बोलता है. इफ यू आर नॉट टैलेंटेड, इफ यू कांट, यू वोंट बी एबल टू सस्टेन इन द इंडस्ट्री, इज व्हाट आई फील.
It is the most beautiful fraud in the world. This industry requires you to also be a people's person. But I was still getting the work, you know, that, you know, I needed. Not the work exactly that I wanted, maybe, but like the work that I needed to get by. For me, it's not so much nepotism. For me, it's more about like maybe favoritism.
While some star kids have been candid about their privileges.
Is there a privilege for people who are born in the film industry? Absolutely. Mm. There absolutely is privilege. Mm. Would it be easier for somebody in my place or another child who has been born, knows everybody from the time that they are born? Everybody knows them from the time that they are born. They socialize at times. They go to each other's events. Mm. Would it be easier for them to have access to someone, to pick up the phone and call someone, to meet someone, to pitch a script to someone, to offer their services as an actor or an actress to someone? 100%. There's no denying that.
What are your thoughts on this entire thing?
I think the people that need to be asked, because are the people who are the decision makers. And in films, there's only one decision maker, and that's the audience. The audience dictates to everyone and everything of how a film should be made, what the budget should be, what kind of star cast it should have. At the end of the day, we work for the audience and they decide who gets to work, who doesn't, and whether they want to patronize that film or not. And depending on how that film does, that decides whether that actor, director, producer are worthy of being given another chance. So the audience is the be-all and end-all as far as I'm concerned.
There have also been those star kids who have seen the flip side and not made it big despite their illustrious Bollywood connections.
If you're from a film fraternity and if you are, you know, born in a film family, then no matter what you do, the glass is always going to be considered half empty. For a film star's son or daughter, you've got to keep proving yourself again and again and again. Then it takes a few years for them. People then start thinking, okay, now we accept that you've come here and you've achieved whatever you have because of your hard work. But why does it take so long? I think that's something I think people have to answer that. I don't know why everyone is a bit harder. They're a bit more judgmental about people who come from films.
And even Sushant Singh Rajput, for that matter, opened up during a press conference in 2017 when he was asked about his opinion on the existence of nepotism.
Nepotism can peacefully coexist with the fact that if you allow new talents from outside to also to flourish and encourage them, then there's no problem with nepotism. But if you don't allow that, then there's a problem, and I think that the whole structure of the industry would collapse.
After this controversial year, Kangana, known for brazen honesty, once again came out in the public domain in 2019 to speak about a feud with Bollywood biggies at the India Today conclave.
Film industry is absolutely classist, you know, and so is the rest of the society. So the system where it works for certain people the way it is, they were definitely going to resist when you're going to challenge it. At that point of time, you feel really intensely about it, but later on, you definitely do not have really strong emotions. How Karan mocked me on IFA's stage and called me, you know, sort of on nepotism. And as he said, I'm jobless and I'm looking for a job from him or something like that. I mean, look at my talent and look at your movies. I mean, really? He really called me jobless in London on some platform. So no matter what the time is or what the era is, I will always think that some people really needed a bit of a dose of Chavan Prash or something at some point.
And later on in 2020, Sushant Singh Rajput's untimely demise only triggered this never-ending debate on nepotism. Controversy's favourite child, Kangana, not only blamed the industry for continuously failing Sushant and his dreams of making it big in Bollywood, but she also continued to make headlines after the late actor's friend Samuel Hokip took everyone by surprise with his social media post where he pondered over an alleged relationship with Sushant Singh Rajput and Sara Ali Khan, who worked together in Kedarnath. Kangana was quick to jump in and in fact even questioned, why were star kids so prone to dump vulnerable outsiders when it conveniently suited them? That's not all. She further went on to hit out at Sushant's last girlfriend, Riya Chakrabarty, calling her a vulture. The actor took to social media and wrote, news of SSR and Sara affair was all over the media. Apparently, they were even sharing a room during their outdoor. Why these fancy nepotism kids show dreams to vulnerable outsiders and then publicly dump them? No wonder he fell for a vulture post that. The nepotism debate escalated to an extent that even the film Salak 2, starring Alia Bhatt, who is the daughter of filmmaker Mahesh Bhatt, faced a lot of backlash. With the hashtag boycott calls, the movie predictably sank without a trace at the box office. So yes, clearly the year 2020 wasn't too kind for some, especially after Sushant Singh Rajput's tragic demise, which blew open the nepotism debate to controversial new heights. Entertainment Bureau, India Today.
Apart from nepotism, Sushant Singh Rajput's death also opened another controversial topic in Bollywood, which is drug usage. And famous faces like Deepika Padukone, Rakul Preet and Sara Ali Khan were actually called by the NCB for questioning. Let's take a look at the story.
Bollywood is no stranger to tales of drug use, abuse and addiction, and the investigation of the untimely demise of Sushant Singh Rajput has brought under the spotlight Bollywood's old, tangled-up tale of drug use and some of its favourite actors. The Narcotics Bureau widened its probe into Sushant Singh Rajput's death and its links to drugs. Sushant's girlfriend, Riya Chakraborty, was questioned by the Narcotics Control Bureau after drug links had emerged in Sushant's death. Riya, in her statement, had confirmed that Sushant was addicted to drugs before she met him. Riya named Sara Ali Khan, who starred with Sushant in her debut film Kedarnath in 2018. In her statement to NCB, Riya alleged that Sushant got addicted to drugs during the shoot of Kedarnath. Deepika Padukone also came under the NCB net after her chats with manager Karishma Prakash went public. In the chats, Deepika allegedly sought hashish from her manager for a party at Coco Club. Another Bollywood starlet who found herself at the center of the drug storm was Shraddha Kapoor. Shraddha Kapoor was grilled by the NCB regarding her connection with Jaya Saha and her chats seeking CBD oil. She denied drug consumption and she said she wanted CBD oil for external use. Jaya Saha allegedly was part of a WhatsApp group that had Bollywood superstars. The conversations in this group were mostly about drugs. However, Bollywood's tryst with drugs has been an ongoing battle.
Sanjay Dutt reportedly dabbled with all kinds of drugs for as many as 12 years before being packed off to rehab in America by father Sunil Dutt.
Well, I got onto drugs in college. It used to be ke matlab ke nahi piyo to you're not in the scene kind of a thing. And I started that, but you know, I got so hooked onto it that it took me about 10 years to get out.
Actor Ranbir Kapoor, who played Sanjay Dutt in his biopic Sanju, has also confessed of being hooked to alcohol and experimenting with marijuana while shooting for Rockstar. Prateek Babbar reportedly came out sober from rehab in 2017. The actor had reportedly admitted that he was hooked on to drugs when he was just 13 years old. Prateek started with hashish and gradually started doing hard drugs such as cocaine, as per reports. Fardeen Khan was arrested by Mumbai police in 2001 for possession of cocaine. The case against Fardeen closed in 2012 as he was let off. Fardeen reportedly admitted that his addiction created a lethal dependency on the substances he was using. In July 2019, Bollywood's High and Mighty came under the scanner when Punjab MLA Manjinder Singh Sirsa shared a video of Karan Johar's party and claimed that drugs were used in the party. Sirsa even asked the police to take action against those present in the party.
Agli baar phir koi dekhega ki are yaar chahe wo isliye ho ki main puri raat shooting kar raha tha aur agle din thaka hoonga, they'll be like, are you looking drunk, test do. या जवाब दो या जस्टिफिकेशन दो देन यू लाइक कि देन आई थॉट कि इट्स नॉट द राइट वे ऑफ गोइंग इट विल बी एज इम्पल्सिव अ रिएक्शन एज द रिएक्शन ऑफ द accusation.
It's ridiculous. And I've said that the next time there are people who make these allegations, baseless allegations and accusations, we will deal with that very strictly and on legal grounds if need be, because this will not be tolerated again.
In late 2019, the Drug Enforcement Agency, or America's DEA, exposed actress Mamta Kulkarni's husband, Vicky Goswami, and Kim Sharma's ex-husband, Ali Punjani. Both Goswami and Punjani were involved in one of the biggest drug rackets, which was linked to a former aide of Dawood Ibrahim. Even Kangana Ranaut shared a video in March 2020 where she confessed that she had been a drug addict when she was a teenager.
डेढ़ दो साल में मैं एक फिल्म स्टार थी, एक ड्रग एडिक्ट थी. मेरी जिंदगी में इतने सारे कांड चल रहे थे कि मैं ऐसे लोगों के हाथों में लग चुकी थी कि जहां से मुझे शायद मौत ही निकाल सकती.
Consumption of drugs remains an open secret in the film industry, and it remains to be seen if the authorities will ever be able to weed out the drug menace. Entertainment Bureau, India Today.
Hello and welcome to the show where we are discussing the late actor Sushant Singh Rajput. Now, after the actor's death, there were people like his therapist who came out and said that the actor was suffering from depression, while his family and Bollywood colleagues like Kangana Ranaut vociferously said that the actor was indeed not suffering from depression. So let's take a look at actually some of the big famous Bollywood faces who have come out openly and talked about their struggle with mental health.
I've been to a doctor. Clinically depressed.
I found sleep. I found comfort in sleep because I felt like that was my escape.
In a film industry where the pressure to always stay relevant and in vogue is a big unsaid rule, it is not uncommon for actors to struggle with their mental illness. A discussion on mental health ensued after SSR's untimely demise. And Kangana Ranaut had her two bits to save there as well. She lashed out at Deepika Padukone, calling her battle with depression fake. This tweet was based on Deepika's earlier post where she talked about depression and mental health 6 days after Sushant Singh Rajput died on the 14th of June. Kangana further shared two more tweets slamming Deepika. She wrote, "Truth remains, there is no valid medical proof of mental illness. It has become new witch hunt of genuine talent by mediocrity. Every extraordinary individual is being subjected to unfair judgments and virtual emotional lynching. Hope this stops." If Deepika Padukone says she suddenly got depressed for a breakup which happened 10 years ago, we believe her. So give me and Sushant the same respect. If I say I'm not mentally ill, or if Sushant's father says he wasn't mentally ill, believe us also, na? Why are you forcing illness on us? Kangana's vociferous accusations did not end there. Even 2 months after Sushant's demise, the actor not only referred to Deepika as a self-proclaimed mental illness patient, but also called Ranbir Kapoor a serial skirt chaser. She also claimed that no one dared call these A-listers a psycho or a rapist. This battle with depression was considered taboo and never spoken about until recently, when Bollywood A-listers like Deepika Padukone came out clean about their battle with depression. Several actors chose to talk about their experiences on World Mental Health Day.
I'm not ashamed.
And urged people to remove the fear of being judged. One such personality was Aamir Khan's daughter Ira, who in an Instagram post revealed that she has been clinically depressed for more than 4 years. On the occasion, Ira shared a video in which she opened up about her mental health battle.
I've been to a doctor. I'm clinically depressed.
She began the video by saying, "Hi, I'm depressed. I have been for more than 4 years now. I have been to a doctor and I'm clinically depressed. I'm doing much better now. For over a year now, I wanted to do something for mental health.
but I wasn't sure what to do.
See what happens. Hopefully, we'll get to know ourselves slightly better, understand mental illness slightly better.
She was also quoted saying, "Let's start from where I started. What do I have to be depressed about? Who am I to be depressed? I have everything, right?"
So, let's start from where I started. What do I have to be depressed about? Who am I to be depressed? I have everything, right?
Soon after Ira, SRK's daughter Suhana's cryptic post about a nervous breakdown went viral. The post shared by Suhana only had the word nervous breakdown in it, and people came to ponder upon how there could be more to it than just that word. She simply shared a still from Pedro Almodovar's 1988 film, Women on the Verge of a Nervous Breakdown, and captioned the image as Women on the Verge of a Nervous Breakdown. This has led to a lot of speculation over whether Suhana is also on the verge of a breakdown. Actors like Deepika Padukone, Anushka Sharma, Shah Rukh Khan, Tiger Shroff, among others, have openly spoken about their struggles, encouraging fans to treat depression like the medical condition that it is, and not a taboo topic which cannot be mentioned in social circles. Deepika Padukone, who was diagnosed with depression in 2014, has spoken about her battle with it, calling for greater public discussion to help tackle the mental health crisis. She also revealed that while battling with depression, all she wanted to do was sleep, as she didn't have to deal with the reality while being asleep. Padukone, post defeating her depression, also took a step ahead in this journey and established a center for mental health by the name Live, Love, Laugh Foundation in 2015 to help people who are going through the same.
I'd be scared to wake up. I didn't want to wake up. I wanted to always, you know, I found sleep. I found comfort in sleep because I felt like that was my escape. And like waking up was a struggle.
Shah Rukh Khan also had to fight this dreaded mental health condition when he was already in a tremendous amount of pain due to his shoulder surgery in 2010. The superstar was quoted as saying, "Due to the shoulder injury and the suffering, I got into a depression mode. But now I'm out of it. I feel happy and boosted with energy." While depression today still continues to be treated as a taboo, these Bollywood stars have managed to break through the shackles of conviction and urged people to follow and lead the path of normalizing mental health conditions. A cause which needs to be spoken about much more. Entertainment Bureau, India Today.
Well, that's all we could pack in this show today, where we spoke about serious issues like nepotism and drug abuse in Bollywood. Make sure you stay tuned to India Today to catch all your latest news and entertainment updates. Goodbye.